Welcome to TOS TV, your digital first Pan-African news network. I am Abigail Okwande, and this is TOS National News. On Tuesday, Boko Haram insurgents attacked Maiduguri, the capital of Borno State. Since the attack, which took place in the evening, about 10 people have been confirmed dead, while 60 people have been injured. The attack was confirmed by the state governor, Baba Ganazulum. In a shared text message, the military claimed to have repelled the attack while announcing 5 deaths, and according to reports, an undisclosed military source said the insurgent launched rocket bombs which landed in crowded areas of the state's capital. The state governor visited some of the injured victims and expressed sadness over the attack. He said that this is a new form of attack and there is an urgent need to strategize to forestall further occurrences. Kogi West Senator Smart Adeyemi and his Abia South counterpart Eyinaya Abaribe clashed over the former's comments where he referred to the Abia State Governor Okezie Ikpeazu as a champagne-drinking man. While contributing to a motion on safe school initiative in Nigeria, Senator Adeyemi reacted to a social media post that berated the Kogi State Governor Yahaya Bello. This accusation was linked to Senator Eyinaya Abaribe, Abia South representative in the Senate. Adeyemi has said while some governors like Bello were committed to the welfare and protection of their people, the people of Abia were being governed by drunkards. He went on to say, and I quote, "Abia people are impoverished more than ever before. Abia people are unfortunate," end of quote. Adeyemi was cautioned at this point against the use of an unparliamentary language and urged to apologize to the governor of Abia State. Today, Wednesday, the Nigeria Center for Disease Control confirmed 1,879 COVID-19 deaths, 53,187 cases, and 129,943 recoveries since March of 2020. They also announced the day before the inclusion of the Ondo State Public Health Laboratory to the NCDC Molecular Laboratory Network and noted that testing at any public laboratory in the NCDC network is free of charge. The NCDC had said in an earlier report that the new B1.525 variant has been detected among cases in 5 states in Nigeria and has also been reported in other countries in travelers from Nigeria. However, researchers and scientists are conducting studies to understand the extent to which this new variant has impact on immunity transmissibility, diagnostic severity, and already approved vaccines. The Nigeria's Governors Forum has said that even if it is to engage in dialogue with bandits, it will do all that is required for peace to return to the nation. Dr. Kayode Fayemi, chairman of the NGF, made this known on Tuesday when he led some members of the forum on a solidarity visit to the Niger State Governor, Sani Bello, in Mina. In his words, and I quote, "We also need to explore other avenues as side by side with whatever the security institutions are doing, if that means engaging in dialogue. We may not have a choice. We may have to do that. Anything to help us to deal with this immediate crisis and then to begin to address on a much more longer time basis the root causes of the social dislocation responsible for what we are witnessing all around us," end of quote. You are watching TOS National News on your digital first Pan-African news network, TOS TV. We'll be back after the break, so stay tuned. Welcome back. You are still watching National News on TOS TV. The Corps Marshal, Federal Road Safety Corps, FRRC, Dr. Boboye Oyeyemi, directed commanding officers on Tuesday to commence immediate clampdown on rickety vehicles plying Nigerian roads. This clampdown is an important part of organized efforts of the Corps in the year 2021 to reduce road traffic crashes across the country. Mr. Oyeyemi said that the operation, which will be conducted nationwide, forms part of the Corps' intentions to enhance the tempo of its operational activities and create a safer monitoring environment in the country. This is based on the realization of its 2021 strategic goals, which include the reduction of road traffic crashes by 15% and fatalities by 20%. He highlighted the health, safety, and economic benefits of regular vehicle maintenance and noted that if drivers and vehicle owners adhere to constant maintenance of their vehicle, the safety of lives and properties will be enhanced. The Nigerian Communications Commission, NCC, has said that the Nigeria's telecommunications industry is one of the sectors whose performances lifted the country out of recession in the fourth quarter of 2020, contributing 12.45% to the country's GDP. According to the NCC Director of Public Affairs, Dr. Ikechukwu Adinde, telecommunications and information services under information and communication grew by 17.64% in the fourth quarter of 2020. From 17.36% in the third quarter of 2020. In the latest report by the Nigerian Bureau of Statistics, agriculture, industries and services sector, under which telecommunications is characterized, made contributions of 26.95%, 18.77% and 54.28% respectively. This points to the fact that the telecommunications trade, services and crop production are the main drivers of Nigeria's exit from recession. Northern elders under the Forum of the Northeast Elders for Peace and Development have cautioned renowned Sheikh Abubakar Gumi, Islamic cleric, against justifying armed banditry and other associated crimes affecting the North, disassociating themselves from comments credited to Gumi, where he accused the Nigerian military of triggering the raging banditry in the parts of the North. The elders accused the fiery Islamic cleric of making wild and false claims. According to report, the cleric made statement on February 23rd, maintaining the military had carried out the said campaign between 2010 and 2015. But reacting to the allegation, the Northern Elders insisted that Gumi's allegations were not a representation of the position of the region, saying the public must see same as personal sentiments of the cleric. You are watching TOS News 360. I beg your pardon, you're watching TOS National News on your digital First Pan-African News Network, TOS TV. Still ahead, business and sports. Do stay tuned. Thanks for staying tuned. In business, the House Committee on Local Content interrogated some of the parties in the construction contract in Abuja on February 23rd, explaining why the Nigerian contractors in the project were swapped for Chinese after the project had been approved by the Federal Executive Council. The House of Representatives is currently probing the breach of Nigeria's laws on local content in the execution of the federal government project in the construction of a gas pipeline from Ajaokuta, Kogi State to Kano State. The committee probed the Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation's Chief Operating Officer, Gas and Power, Yusuf Usman, who represented the NNPC Group Managing Director of the NNPC, Mele Kyari, to explain their role in the controversial project. The committee also directed the clerk to write a corporate affairs commission to provide more information of owners of the company involved in the project. Still in business, the market capitalization of the Nigerian Stock Exchange for the third consecutive day on February 24th reported increase in growth by 27 billion naira. Similarly, the All Share Index, which opened at 33,436.61, inched 78.32 points of 0.23 points to close at 33,514.93 due to price growth by some highly capitalized equities. Seplat led the gainers table during the day, appreciating by 9.98 naira to close at 485 naira per share. Guinness following with a gain of 3.10 naira to close at 66.10 naira. And Okumo Oil Palm increased by 1.50 naira to close at 64.50 per share. P PZ Industries added 1.05 to close at 22.05 naira, while Stanbic IBTC grew by 99 kobo to close at 32.49 naira per share. On the other hand, Nestle posted the highest loss to lead the losers table, shedding 16.50 naira to close at 903.50 per share. And in sports, Halima Ayinde, Super Falcons midfielder, has accepted the decision of the team's coach, Randy Waldrum, to expand the players' span to let in younger players into the team. Halima gave assurance to Nigerian fans to expect greater things from her and her club this year in the national jersey team. She went further to explain the relationship between the coach and the team as very smooth and cordial one. She also expressed the joy of her and her team members after winning the tournament and a great achievement from the 14-month course. Still in sports, former Super Eagles defender Ifeanyi Udeze has said the Enyimba team can qualify for the quarterfinals of the CAF Confederation Cup with adequate plan and methods set in place. Udeze said the Aba-based team to ensure they win their home games and pick points outside Nigeria when the group stage begins. He also advised them to avoid distraction in their games, adding that past experience should aid them in their campaign. Mr. Udeze also cautioned the Enyimba team to increase their game standard, explaining that the next phase of the game becomes more difficult than previous experiences. And that's national news on your digital first Pan-African news network, TOS TV. For more updates, visit our website at www.tostvnetwork.com. Do follow and like TOS TV Network on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And remember to subscribe on YouTube. Just stay with us and enjoy more programs on TOS TV Network. I am Abigail Okwade. Bye for now. We'll be right back.